And Wizard, welcome to another edition of FAQ. It's number 14. It's FAQ number 14. This edition is, I don't know why, but I've been getting an influx of negative comments. So, I don't know who they are. They're just a bunch of turkeys, if you ask me. So, I'm just gonna do a real quick FAQ and address some of these turkeys because I can't just let it go because I do read every single comment and I try and answer them all, especially the questions. I can't get to everyone, but I'm trying. So, let me just address a few of the good ones and a few of the negative ones too. I'm gonna get my trusty guitar here. I think I might need it. Okay, first one. I think you need to redo Malagueña. It's not really tasteful to just leave the video with glaring faults in playing. What is the level of care with the content you produce? And then, I mean, I did my best. What the hell is a live take? I mean, come on, guy. There's gonna be mistakes. Everything I do has a mistake. There's no way to be perfect. I mean, we're human, so. Then he goes on to say, I don't know their technical term, but the good parts are what I call the melodic ones, where there's like many notes played across the fret with the hands not moving too much. And then other parts, like the single notes being played fast, seem to demonstrate. This guy doesn't even know the terminology for tremolo, or I think what he means is like runs, or bigallo runs, or alternate, whatever it is. If he doesn't even know the terminology, how can I be expected to take his criticism and use it as constructive? Basically, this guy can be gone because he's a big old turkey. Next one. This shit is not flamenco, and rumba flamenco doesn't consist of slapping on the guitar. Oh, is that so? Well, maybe you should take a closer look at some live videos of the Gypsy Kings playing. Well, they're the masters of rumba guitar and they slap their guitar all the time. Now, I'm doing a slap like just kind of thing I made up. It's not really a slap, it's just me doing a golpe with the side of my thumb here. But for regular rumba strumming, you might see in there, there's a little bit of slap. Good Gypsy Kings do that. You might want to look into, I don't know, the legend Manitas de Plata. Yeah, he does that too. And if you look at almost every famous rumbero, they do, at some point, they do golpes on the guitar. So, you're a big old turkey.
He's also a cock-smoking douchebag.
Like a Mario sound, LOL, play it flamenco, please. All right, another turkey, whatever. Man, how much time does it take to compose such a melody? I know you don't reply to comments, just being hopeful. Now I'm replying in this video. I don't know, it's different every time, man. Sometimes I start with chords and I find notes within the chords and then boom, a melody starts to pop out. Sometimes I wake up with a melody in my head or I walk around and a melody pops up and I have to go find it on the guitar. The melody kind of just creates itself and then it's my job to flesh it out. Hope that answers the question. Great question. What a dream would it be of seeing him do a duet with another flamenco guitarist? And he wants to see me do a duet with Paola Hermosin. She is fantastic. If you guys don't know her, go check her out. She's a wonderful guitar player, just beautiful. And what's really cool is that she also gives you some insight on the forms and format of the songs that she's playing and sometimes some of the history behind it. So very informative, educational, and entertaining. Go check her out. Great comment, thank you. This guy says, thanks for producing the guitar profiles. Do you ever use traditional picado anymore? I've seen you doing the alter nail, but of course I use that technique all the time. It's just that sometimes this is a little bit easier. The alternail, where I just use my index like a pick. You've probably heard me talking about it. Now, piccolo. Yes, I use it all the time. As a matter of fact, one of the last videos I just did called the Tanguillos. Use the alternail at all. It's all picado and pretty challenging fast runs, and sometimes I want to go faster than my picado will allow me to play, so I gotta use the alternail sometimes. It's actually changed my life, and it's given me some freedom so I can worry about the music more than being able to pull it off with the technique that I have. You know what I'm saying? That's a great comment though. How do you play bass notes while doing the alternail? Consists of some legatos and just some trickery to get to let go and then do your thumb and then bring it back. See what I'm talking about? Great question. To all these people complaining about people disliking this video, while Ben is skilled, he's quite pedestrian compared to Antonio Rey or Grisha Gorchev. Tranquila. Oh, nice use of the Spanish word tranquila. Yeah, you're a big old turkey, okay?
Don't forget douchebag cocksmoker.
I know that I'm not as good as Antonio Rey or Grisha Gorchev. Of course I'm not. I don't think anyone in the world is. They're the top in the world. You know what I mean? Okay, but pedestrian? Why don't you go pick on some other guitar players, you know? There's plenty of guitar players that are much more famous than me that are... So go pick on them. The girl's dance is good. You're a genius on the guitar. And you dress like an idiot. Turkey. Be gone. Not to nitpick here, but as with your tremolo, you're not resting your thumb on the next string ready to play it. Not to nitpick, huh? Well, that's literally exactly what you're doing, is nitpicking. By the way, you're a big old turkey. Oh, this one says, you turned a classic into garbage. But he into turkey. Next time, into. It's one word, okay? Nothing compared to Paco. This guy is great, but Paco makes him sound like an amateur at best. Yeah, another backhanded compliment, just like I keep telling you. Well, yeah, obviously it's nothing compared to Paco. Paco was the best. He still is the best. Nobody's going to ever be as complete a guitarist as Paco de Lucia. What I did that I don't think you understand is that I did a solo arrangement of Entre Dos Aguas. Okay, everybody plays it with the rhythm guitar. Even Paco plays it with the rhythm guitarist, his brother, most of the time. But I tried to play it as a solo guitar, meaning I had to play the bass notes and the melody and some kind of driving rhythm at the same time. I don't do it as fast, and I don't do it nearly as spectacular, but I do it in a different way that can be done on a solo guitar. But everybody wants to complain about how it's not as good as Paco's version. Yeah, it never will. Nobody's as good as Paco's version. So Be gone, you turkey. And guess what, turkeys? That's the last one. Got a couple great questions and comments in there, but mostly just a bunch of negative gobble gobble. So, hope this was entertaining for everybody. I have a little bit of a chip on my shoulder. I'm going to try and, you know, get back into practicing. I'm trying to maintain a positive outlook here, but I'm not going to tolerate bullying.
What's the matter? Mommy not here to dress you? Hey, I'm talking to you, Mom. Come on, make a move!
And I'm not going to get political, but I don't think anyone should. So with that, I'm going to leave you guys. Thanks for watching another FAQ. Please like, subscribe, notification, all that stuff if you don't mind. And I'm going to be putting out some great guitar content, so stay tuned. We'll see you on the next one.
I'm the best!